their first show in 5 years. They had a new singer who appeared like a frightening corpse, as if they had just crawled out of the grave. Pelle Ohlin called himself Dead. When he was a child, Dead got in an ice skating accident and passed away. He was taken to a hospital to be declared dead on arrival. But then miraculously, young Pelle revived. But due to the consequences of the amount of time his brain went without a pump of ichor, being at the mere age of 10 years old, there grew within Pelle a creepy fascination with the experience. He was considering suicide quite often from then on. Death wasn't unfamiliar to the child, the path Pelle set on. Dead had visions that he would tell his friends and fellow artists of afterlife. To many, he was a mystical enigma, and considered an eccentric band frontman that brought confusion to the black metal scene. The way he was initially found was through sending his demo tape in a box with a decaying mouse. He was known to sleep with dead birds, rodents, or whatever he could really get his hands on under his bed, and would bury his clothing items in the ground to give it a rotten or decrepit feel. The stench of cessation was his inhaler. He would huff the creature's remains from a bag before shows to inspire and remind himself of his dedicated existence. Dead wasn't fond of all animals, though. He had a deep hatred for feline animals. Committed to terminate them on sight, he supposedly kept a spear on his porch, according to dark legend. The strange collector of dead animals also partook in self-mutilation in the form of theatrical exhibitions. It wasn't uncommon to get Dead's blood on you if you were viewing their show. Live on stage, Dead sliced open his arms badly at nearly each gig, leaking blood onto the audience as he sung about death and supernatural concepts. He genuinely enjoyed seeing the reactions. After shows, he is imagined reveling in his open wounds, sitting on the tour bus, relishing the effects it had on his consciousness, as he dreamt of his interpreted existence of being undead. Pig heads were mounted on spikes on stage and even thrown into the crowd by Dead, revolting some enough to check out and leave. One of his fellow black metalist's words on Dead's performances was simple, yet revealing, on how he fared in his own circles.
Why? This performance. Why?
Despite the Swedish phenomenon's onstage antics, he was a quiet artist that had a sort of black humor. Some of his unusual thoughts were documented in lyric form, and the different feelings were evident and separated themselves from contemporary black metal artists. The depressed, death-seeking attitude and viewpoint on reality was fascinating to all within the circle. But what had caused this bizarre passion, or lack thereof? Dead's first time in the afterlife before he returned was short-lived. However, it seemed to have managed to take over every aspect of his unordinary life once it was over. Some think this could have been a case of Cotard syndrome, an eerie disease that causes people to chalk their existence up to delusion and make sense of their world by believing they had passed away at some point. It's sensationalized as walking corpse syndrome and life as a zombie, leaving the victim sometimes feeling extremely nervous, depressed, and suicidal. One account describes a man who threw himself out of a moving vehicle. He said that he did it because he thought he was trapped in an eternity where nothing is real, and that perhaps dying again would recover his former self. This may could have been a mix of Cotard syndrome rooted in self-misidentification, which happens when someone looks at the reflection and believes their person is a doppelganger of sorts. This delusion would involve brain impairment to the point of lack of emotional response when blaring sounds, unexpected touches, or unsettling images occur. These people affected by Cotards may assume they are just dead or no longer exist. One sufferer describes the harrowing state. I was doomed to wander forever in a world that wasn't mine, in a body that wasn't mine. I was doomed to be surrounded by creatures and so-called people that mimicked the lovely world that I'd once known, but could evoke no emotion. It is possible for the condition to disappear inexplicably. Death, in a medical sense, is when the heart stops beating and cuts off blood supply to the brain. This means the brain's functions also stop and can no longer keep the body alive. Doctors in New York found multiple reports that consciousness lingers long after patients are declared dead. With people who had cardiac arrest and came back, they'll describe watching doctors and nurses working and having awareness of full conversations, of visual things that were going on that would otherwise not be known to them. They also found the experience of death can be very different for individual patients. Can one be really dead and their body still live? In the mystic mountains of Tibet, therein lies numerous yogis who evidently succeeded in their path to illumination, so far as to master the mind to the point where they seem to imply control over the process of reincarnation. Since the age of 3, one yogi says, he was able to tell his previous lives and his former sister. Most people die the way some of us are familiar with. The skin turns pale or yellow. You pinch it and it's insubstantial compared to before. There's no robust or pink. But with most of the best practitioners, you pinch it, it stays the way it was, and it goes back and it has tension still. There's warmth in their core. And the face is like it is in life. In Bhutan, one local Buddhist master, Yejun Richen, was dead for more than 1 month and never changed. Tibetan yogi Gyanga Rinpoche grasped the ancient Buddhist teaching so well that it granted a unique ability to extend his life out. The Dalai Lama asked him to live a little longer, to pass along his teachings, and His Eminence agreed to stay and help his people to the age of 100. When the time came that Rinpoche was done serving the younger aspiring yogis, he told all of his students he would die today. Then he had his attendant make a tea for him. He drank numerous cups just like normal, then sat up to do his prayers. He did a prayer on everyone around, then said, "It is time for me to pass away." He rested his cheek upon his hand like Buddha and went into his sleep. The monks, when asked, said they are not supposed to reveal the ins and outs of meditation to avoid misleading people, as the knowledge that led up to this level of mastery is kept under secrecy through vows made by dedicated monks after years of consistent yogic training from archaic teachings with intact techniques, unblemished by exotic forms of meditation done by lines of people who have not underwent actual yogic training. They strive in the footsteps of past masters to keep the secrets of meditation in respect and tradition of sworn silence. The reason, according to the elders, is to maintain purity, as if you let it fall in the hands of the masses, if you boil it down, it would all degrade into ego-centered showmanship,